In the previous video, you learned how to work with four operation modes and export a project to HTML5. The output uses the HTML5 standards that allow learners to view and interact with the content on the World Wide Web. Today, you will have a more comprehensive understanding of this feature in ActivePresenter 8. To export projects to HTML5, open the Export tab and click this button. This opens a dialog containing two tabs, General and Reporting. The General tab provides you with many settings for the final output. In the Operation Modes section, you can choose the modes to export to HTML5. This option is to generate the HTML index page. It contains the entry to open all the selected modes. The next options are applied to the tutorial, practice, and test modes. This one is the maximum time for users to complete the project. This option determines the overall pass or fail result of learners when they take a test. Choose one from the list and type the value to satisfy your needs. The options in the content section are applied to visual and audio elements of projects. Select this checkbox to allow viewing the HTML5 content on browsers that don't support MP4 and MP3, but support WebM and AUG. If you select this checkbox, the object that gains focus in your project will have a dashed outline. You can click here to hide this notification. It appears to meet the requirements of some browsers. This option is used to make the fonts look consistent between platforms and devices. Click here to choose the embed fonts you want. If you don't select it, the fonts might be changed in the output. The next option only affects images that are exported in JPEG format. The higher the quality, the larger the output file size. This one applies to PNG format only. It specifies the relative compression levels in this list. The higher the compression level, the smaller the output file size, and the longer it takes to export. The last two options specify the audio bit rate and the quality of videos in the output, if any. The higher the value, the higher the quality, and the larger the output file size. The output section lets you know the location and further settings for them. This unique reference number is used for reporting the test result. You can rename the folders containing related files of the output here. The last option is to set the prefix to the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files in the folder. It may be used in the scenario that the system needs to put files of multiple projects into one folder. Lastly, you can discard all changes and go back to the default settings by clicking here. Let's check the output folder after working with the General tab. These are the related folders mentioned in the further settings. The prefix customized earlier is added in these files. These are HTML5 outputs corresponding to the selected modes. The other tab in the dialog is Reporting. From version 8.2, the tab offers you report options like this. You can choose between doing not send the report or sending the report through the HTTP request. After that, choose any of reporting formats here. This one is the HTTP address of a server-side script that will process the report data. For more information, refer to the video How to Send Quiz Report to Google Sheets or Email Box. And find the detailed description in the ActivePresenter version 8.4 user manual on page 289. When satisfied with all the settings and adjustments, just click the OK button to start exporting. That's it.